Conditional formatting is exactly what it sounds like. As conditions change, so does the formatting or look of your sheet change. It makes a sheet go from this to this. It makes the information easier to scan automatically, and you can apply conditional formatting to cells or entire rows based on what's in your sheet. Let's have a look. To create a conditional formatting rule, I first have to be an admin or owner of the sheet. I click on the conditional formatting icon in the top toolbar and then select Add New Rule. First, I need to set the condition for my rule. Conditions are set at the column level, so you'll first select the column that you want to drive the condition, then set the condition. For example, say I want to format all of my completed tasks, then I want my condition to be when the status column is complete. If the condition is met, the rule will apply the format to the entire row or to specific cells in that row. Next, I click on this format to set the formatting for my rule. In Gantt, calendar, and card views, conditional formatting can update the color of the taskbar. In grid view, you can change the text's font, size, style, color, and background color. In this case, I want to strike through completed tasks. By default, the formatting will be applied to the entire row, but I can specify individual cells by selecting an individual column. I can always see a preview of the applied formatting just to the right in the rule builder. To make a rule with multiple conditions, I click on the drop-down arrow next to the rule and select Add Condition. When there are multiple conditions for a rule, all conditions must be met for the rule to apply. So say I want to highlight the due date for tasks that are incomplete and past due. That's two conditions. I click Add New Rule and set the condition of the status column is not complete. Next, I select Add Condition and set this condition to end date is in the past. Then I set my formatting if both conditions are met. I'm going to make these cells that meet these criteria red and bold so they say danger, danger. Remember, by default, rules apply to the entire row, so I want to change the formatting to apply to just the due date column. When I'm done with the rule builder, I click OK and save my sheet. The conditional formatting is applied immediately. I can edit a rule at any time by clicking on any one of the rules components. And I can also clone, disable, or delete a rule. Finally, when I save my sheet as new or as a template, the conditional formatting rules will transfer, so I won't need to rewrite the rules. It's that simple. Conditional formatting is easy to set up and makes your sheets clear, scannable, and more valuable for your whole team. To learn more, visit the Smartsheet Help and Learning Center.